In the previous episode, we have created a simple socket chat server and we have used Telnet to connect to it. Now we are going to create our own client for this chat written in ReactPHP. And the first thing we need to do is to establish a streaming connection to the server. We create an instance of the connector, which requires an event loop. Import the class here. Connector has a one single method connect. It accepts a connection address of the listening server. In our case, our server is listening on localhost port 8000. Method connect returns a promise. Once the connection is established, this promise fulfills with an instance of the streaming connection. Otherwise, the promise rejects with an exception. In case of exception, we just print the message. Under the hood, connection is a duplex stream. We can write data to it and read something from it. So let's read from the connection. We attach a handler for data event and simply print the received data. Now when we connect to our server, it sends back a welcome message and asks to enter a name. As you can see, this part of our client, reading from the connection, is very simple. But now when we type, nothing happens. So we need to somehow read this input and send it back to the server. To continuously read data from terminal, we use a readable stream and provide a predefined constant as a resource. Now everything we type in terminal becomes available via the stream. We can again listen to data event, and each time a new chunk of data arrives, we write it to the connection and it goes directly to the server. Let's try the client again. The first user connects, enter the name, the second user, another name, we write some messages, one more message, and quit. You see, it works. Actually, the client is ready and is very simple. We have written just a few lines of code. Let's review the code and maybe there is a room for improvement here. First of all, when we read data from one stream and then write it to another stream, which in our case is the connection, this is called piping. Readable stream already has a method for it. Remove all this code and replace it with one single call of pipe method and provide a connection as an argument. Consider this as a shortcut of the previous code. Then take a look at this bit of code. Do you notice something here? Maybe now it doesn't look very obvious. Let me change something. Instead of echoing, we create a writable stream for printing data to the terminal. And instead of calling echo, we use the stream and write data to it. Now it should be clear that again we are piping data from one stream into another. So let's replace everything with a pipe call. And now we end up with two pipe calls. Take a look at what we have. Data received from the terminal input is being written to the connection. And also, everything received from the connection is being written to the terminal output. Looks like a chain, right? Exactly. Two these calls may be chained. Pipe data from input to the connection and then from the connection into the output. As a result, our client looks extremely simple. All we have to do is to manage the data flow between the terminal and the connection. And because the connection is a duplex stream, we take an advantage of piping the data between the streams. The chat is done. We have a server and a client both written in ReactPHP. Despite the fact that we are dealing with such low-level things as sockets, the code doesn't look complex or scary. On the opposite, everything is clear and simple.